Next question is from Nick Folkman. What exercise helps improve knee pain and functionality?
You know, back in the day, I would focus on the knee joint whenever somebody had issues with the knee joint. So this, someone would tell me, oh, my knees hurt when I squat or, you know, when I lunge, and I would look at the IT band and I would look at, you know, the knee function and, okay, you know, did you get any imaging done? Is there chondromalacia under the kneecap and blah, blah, blah.
Hips and ankle.
Later on, exactly. Later on, it really, I started to figure out that it had way more to do with the ankle and hips than it did with the knee. Because the knee joint, I mean, it bends and it extends. That's it. It doesn't rotate. It doesn't bend laterally. I mean, it's got ligaments in there actually to prevent it from doing anything other than flexing and extending. But the ankle moves all kinds of different directions. The foot moves in lots of different directions, you know, not even just the ankle, just the foot. And so does the hip. So if the ankle and the hip and the foot lack strength and stability in any of the directions that the knee doesn't move, then all that support is going straight to those ligaments in the knee that prevent it from doing that. And then you start to develop.
Think about how much pressure the knee is taking on constantly with gravitational forces going straight down. You know, where's the weak link in the kinetic chain? You know, it's going to take on a lot of that stress. And now if it's taking on a lot of those, it's not tracking properly, like any little thing isn't, you know, you don't have proper mobility in your ankles or your hips aren't rotating like they normally could, and the knee has to kind of adjust to that. It's going to add all that excess of pressure to an already stressed out joint.
Now, there's value in building all the muscles that surround the knee, right? So your quads and hamstrings and your calves, like having strong muscles that are around your knee support the knee too. So there's tremendous value in that. I remember when I tore my ACL and MCL, and the doctor was so blown away on how stable I still was, even with losing those ligaments.
Yep.
But that was because of all the muscle that I had developed around it. So there's obvious value in building the muscles around. But when I think of clients that would complain of knee problems, to your point, Sal, yeah, it's almost always related to poor, you know, hip mobility and or ankle mobility, and then the knee is just carrying all the stress. And so that's the first place that I go now. If someone complains about their knee, is we're going to look right away to the hips and the ankle and address there.
Nine out of 10 times is what I find the issue. I mean, think about it this way. You know, there's a submission in jiu-jitsu called a heel hook, where somebody takes they trap your leg and then they hook around your heel, and then they twist your leg, and it looks like you're attacking the foot. But the reality is the joint that gets damaged in a heel hook is the knee. Because imagine this for a second. So here's the knee joint, right? And the knee joint flexes and extends. That's it. And there are things that prevent it from twisting and sliding and bending laterally. And let's say somebody grabs your ankle and starts to twist your leg to the outside. Well, what's going to happen is your hip is going to allow your leg to twist. But what happens when the hip runs out of room? Let's say you're too tight and you can't twist anymore. Well, now the pressure's going to the knee.
A lot more torque.
Right on the knee, and it's the meniscus holding things together, but that can only do so much, and then the meniscus eventually tears or gets strained. So when you have knee problems and knee pain, it's almost always, in my experience, because your hips and your ankles just aren't doing what they're supposed to. I mean, the kneecap supposed to track nicely in this groove. Well, if it's always pushing to the side laterally because your hips aren't doing what they're supposed to, your ankles aren't doing what they're supposed to, well, now your kneecap is tracking kind of weird. Maybe at first you don't feel any pain, but you work out this way, you walk this way, you go on hikes. Next thing you know, you're like, man, my knee always bothers me. Like, what the hell's going on? Then you go to the doctor. They do some imaging and they go, oh, the bottom of your kneecap, it's all chewed up. We need to go in there and clean it up. So they go in there and they clean up all the pieces or whatever, and you feel a little better, but you never fix the root cause. And so then you end up with the same problem again, and then eventually you have to get a knee replacement or whatever. So it's all about the surrounding joints that are way more mobile than the knee joint. And if they don't have the support and strength, your knee joint, all those ligaments and tendons and all that cartilage is holding itself together, But over time, you end up developing lots of problems and inflammation.
And a lot of times you'll feel this in your IT, and this is where I didn't fully grasp this as a trainer when I first, I thought, oh, this, I have these knots in my IT, that's, and the IT runs in the front of the patella, and so when I would foam roll the IT, it would relieve the knee, and then my knee wouldn't bother me. And so I blamed it on the IT all the time, and then I'd get clients that would, oh, it's your IT, and you know, and then I'd foam roll them, and then they'd feel relief, and they'd be like, oh, wow. You know, and so I thought I was addressing the issue, but what was happening was all I really was doing was giving them a little bit of instant relief. And the reason why their IT was so tight was because of the lack of mobility and strength and control in the hip.
It was doing what it was supposed to do. It was protecting.
That's right.
You know, the joints.
That's right.
Yeah, your body's smart with that stuff, and you have to trace it back to the root. And this is why it's important to have standards in terms of alignment and optimal alignment, so your joint can travel the way it's supposed to. So to be able to find your way back to that optimal alignment position is something that, you know, we should always kind of be looking at.
Yeah, no, great point. And what we need to understand is that our joints really, we evolved or were designed to last you a lifetime. So, you know, what does that mean? What that means is when you do things properly, right? So although our bodies are kind of like machines, they're actually a little different than machines. A machine, if you use it over and over again, you start to get wear and tear over time. Well, the human bodies, there's this interesting dichotomy going on where when you move a joint, but you do it right and you strengthen it, it actually heals itself and becomes stronger and replenishes itself. So somebody who does proper exercise, even though they're using their joints more than somebody who's sedentary, the person who exercises has healthier joints. So this belief that, oh, yeah, I got bad joints because I've been working out for 30 years. No, you've got bad joints because you've been working out wrong for 30 years. There's movement patterns that are wrong that have been happening and your joints haven't been working optimally. And you're right, Adam, 100%. When something is tight, when your shoulder's tight, your back is tight, your IT band is tight, what your body's literally trying to do is it's trying to minimize movement by tightening the muscles because it senses that something's not moving right. And just loosening up those muscles will make you feel better temporarily, but you're not solving the root cause at all.
Well, that's how you know you have a good trainer, is that they may foam roll you, but then the work's not done, right? So
yes.
You foam roll, and then you would go over to something that works on the mobility in the hip and strengthens and gets control and stability there in the hip. So if you just foam roll and to give yourself temporary relief, and then you go about your normal exercise routine, then you're going to be in that constant, which is where I was for a long time. Yeah, forever.
Foam rolled every time.
Yeah, it was a foam rolled before every training session, and I had to just to give myself enough relief to go train legs and stuff, and not realizing that I wasn't addressing the root cause, which was related to the instability of my hip.